हेलो चिल्ड्रन, सो वंस अगेन वी मीट एंड आई होप दैट यू ऑल मस्ट बी वेरी फाइन, टेकिंग केयर ऑफ योर सेल्फ, टेकिंग प्रिकॉशंस एंड लिसनिंग टू योर पेरेंट्स. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस यू मस्ट बी स्टडिंग ऑल्सो. यू नो दैट द सिचुएशन एट द मोमेंट इज वेरी टफ, इज वेरी हार्ड एंड holiday is okay, you are having partially holiday, but at the same time study is also very important for the child. So study, take your studies very seriously. Now children, today we are going to start with a new poem. That is, the name of the poem itself is The Poem, right? Now it is written by Emmy Lowell. Her full name is Emmy Lawrence Lowell, and she is a writer, the same poet, not only a poet, she is also works on translating books, other works. She also wrote biography, she also wrote essay, and while she wrote biography, she was the one who wrote the biography of the famous writer John Keats. When you will grow up, go to the graduation level, you will be reading more about John Keats. Right. Next, she was born in February 9, 1874 in Brooklyn. Now, Brooklyn is where? In U.S. So, therefore, she is a U.S. citizen. Therefore, she was an American poet. We can call her as a American poet. So Emmy was an American poet, and she died at the age of 51 on May 12, 1927, again where she was born in Brooklyn. She died over there in US. Like about Emmy, I would like to say that Emmy, since she was a girl, she was never sent to school. She obtained her studies, her education. She did her schooling all at home by private tuition, private coaching. The coacher used to come and teach her. Now, since she had not been to the schools and all, she got the education at home. But she started writing poems at the age of 30. She used to work in the library and translate the works of others. And at that working duration, she gained confidence, and at the age of 30, she started writing essays, as a single poet. So, Emmy, now children, Emmy's poem was full of imaginary. So, she was a very famous imaginist poet. Now, what do you mean by imaginist poet? Imaginist poets are when they attempt to produce writing that was filled only with clear, precise images. Like they are talking about the images, describing something about one thing that spoke for themselves, that the image is talking to themselves only, without any unnecessary words. The image is talking about themselves without shelling out any unnecessary words to the listener. So this is imaginary. Now everyone had their own way of writing. All the poets, you can say, have their own way of writing. Talk about William Wordsworth. He was a nature poet. So he used to write up his poem mostly deals with nature. Then William Brecht, he is also a nature poet. So his poems are mostly deals with nature. some poets are about writes about philosophy, some writes about psychology, right? So every poet has their own style of writing, but Emmy's style of writing was imaginary. Her poem was full of imaginary things which is you cannot imagine beyond, you can imagine beyond that also. People don't even go to that depth. She goes to that depth of it and talk about the poem. We'll see in this poem the poem. Now, children, this brief summary I would like to give about the poem before starting. That is the poem, like the poet has highlighted in this poem, the poet has highlighted the importance of wisdom. Wisdom is what? The knowledge and the experiences which you gain in your life. Right. The next point is that she, like the poet, provides a detailed insight of richness of different elements of nature. Nature over here means the nature. What is the nature? Nature means like the rain, sunlight, water, air. They are all nature. So the poet poem, the poet uses the element of nature as the topic, like offer of the poem. Now, over here in this poem, the poem, she uses a simple simple thing. She talks about, what do you see? This is a small plant. This is twig actually, not even a plant. It does not have any root in it. She is talking about a small twig in this poem, which has no root, nothing. So when this twig is planted in the soil, and it is nurtured carefully, by giving water daily, and it is planted in such a place where there is sufficient enough for the rays of the sun to fall on it. So what does a plant only need three things for good growth? That is soil, another is water, and the sunlight. So if this twig is planted in a proper place where there is a provision of good soil, and there it is watered every day, and there is rays of the sun falls directly on the sun properly, this plant will one day grow up into a big plant and give us food. Now this twig has been correlated, her poem, as I said, that she is a very simple, her poem deals with simple language, easy for a reader to understand, and it might be small, very simple, but it has a great meaning to it. Like over here, she's talking about a twig. Now, all the words which she used is interconnected with our daily life, our growth of our character, wisdom, and experience, which becomes fruitful in the later stage. As I told you about Emmy was not sent to school. She was taught at home. Now there are lots of difference between studying at school and studying at home. Studying at school and career. But she took studying alone, she to attain knowledge, and later on she worked very hard and she became a famous writer. Right? Famous writer that she even won many prizes for her work. She also wrote the biography of a very famous writer. which was like is a very great thing. She thinks that it was, she had the opportunity to write about someone who is a great person, right? So in her poem she tells that a twig is if a twig is compared to life that provides happiness, and if we sow this seed in a correct direction and in goodness, like hard work you do, you will be always fruitful, you will be always rewarded. This is the poem about. I am going to read the poem which is on page number 42. The poem, it is written by Emmy Lowell. It is only a little twig with a green bud at the end, but if you plant it and water it and set it where the sunlight will be above it, it will grow into a tall bush with many flowers and leaves which thrush hither and thither sparkling. Now over here the poet, in her simple language, she highlights about the wisdom. She says the wisdom to the reader with a small simple twig. Now this twig, she says that if you grow this twig into the soil which has small buds in it, and you water it daily. And if you water it daily means if you pour water daily and set it where, and you place plant this twig at a place where the soil is good and there is a proper supply or the sun of the rays to fall on it. After some time you will see that this twig grows into a tall bush, the branches jutting out from here and there, and many leaves have come on it, and these leaves are spreading on the branches hither and thither, means growing everywhere. Hither and thither means growing everywhere. And one day this twig becomes such a big tree with many leaves that many flowers appears on it, and these leaves, they are looking fleshy green and bright in the rays of the sun, that it is sparkling. Now the next paragraph, from its root will come freshness, and beneath it has grace blades which will bend and recover themselves and clash on upon another in the blowing wind. Now in this paragraph, second paragraph, the poet says that if a simple looking plant is planted at a right place, in the right direction. Right place means right direction, at a proper place. Proper place means it is indicating to soil of the ground, where the sunlight falls directly without any hindrance, and then this tree will grow. The second line is saying this tree, when the tree grows, this is the surface, Now the roots is here. This root will go right deep into the soil. There with this root, the other thing, and when you water every day, these fibrous plants, you must have read in the bio class, na? A tree always have a fibrous root, which gives support to the tree to grow, stand erect. So if you water the plant every day and the sunlight is sufficient enough, that a tree gets now why sunlight is important over here? Because it is what we have studied in science, photosynthesis, right? Because the plants live on the sunlight, right? So it helps, the sunlight helps to grow. So when it is growing, the roots are going deep into the soil, and along with that, small grasses are also jutting out from there, coming out from the soil. So these grasses, these trees with many leaves on it, makes the atmosphere. Now this is the tree, right? This is the tree. Now this tree is having a many leaves over here. Now these leaves, what do they do? The greenery leaves, what do? They make the air pure. They make the air clean. Why? Because it breathes out oxygen and breathes in carbon dioxide. And what human being does? Human being breathes out carbon dioxide, which these plants observe it, takes it. And they breathe out oxygen, and which we human being take it. So the carbon dioxide is consumed by tree, right? So by the tree, by the green plant. So the poet says that this tree like when they go deep into the soil with many leaves on it, what does it do? It makes the surrounding fresh. It makes the surrounding fresh, and many blades are many tree, small grasses also comes out. Why? And when they come out, that it makes the surrounding beautiful also to look. That when the wind blows, these blades, if they are strong, they will stand erect and they will move slightly. But if the small blades of grass is thin, the strong wind will, what if they are standing like this? When the wind blows, so what will do? The blade will bend down. You know, it is weak over here. So what the poet is trying to say, that if we attain more knowledge, work hard in our life, so it will be beneficial for us. We will be able to stand in the society erect. No matter, now wind is also mentioned over here. So wind means, no matter whatever difficulties comes to you in your life, you will be standing erect. Now like this tree, when this root is penetrating deep into the soil, it is helping the plant to stand erect. No matter how strong wind comes, this tree will not move, will not bend down, will not be uprooted easily. Now in the third paragraph, it is said, but if you take my twig and throw it into a closet. Now if you take this example, and you take the wisdom, you take the knowledge, you take the experience from the others, and you keep it and throw it. Throw it means keep it into a closet. Closet is an enclosed cupboard where unwanted materials are kept. It's in the storeroom. Closet is a small cupboard and where unwanted, like the things which we are not using, we keep it in the cupboard. The thing. So she is saying over here, if you take the knowledge and if you keep this twig in the closet with the mouse trap and blunted tools. Now mouse trap and blunted tools means mouse trap. मतलब लाइक इट इज अ क्लिप टाइप टू कैच द माउस एंड ब्लंटेड टूल्स इज व्हाट अगेन ब्लंटेड टूल शार्प टूल्स लाइक शार्प इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स राइट तो इट विल शिवर्ड एंड वेस्ट राइट तो ओवर हियर द राइटर एमी इज सेइंग दैट इफ यू टेक द नॉलेज एंड कीप इट इन द क्लोजेट with the mouse trap. Matlab like you keeping it within yourself. No, I am not going to share my knowledge. I have spent money on attaining this degree, this knowledge. So why should I share? If I am beneficial, then only I will share, or else I will not share. So if you, the mouse trap means this, and blunt tools means the people with fools. Like you who have no knowledge with less, and you're sitting with those people who are not using your knowledge where it is necessary and sitting dumb. So them truth is related to that. What will happen? Your knowledge, the time, the money, the energy which you have spent will shrink, will wither away, will die one day. Yeah, it is a waste. Why? And all these are a waste. They will be, it will be of no use. If you keep this twig outside from the soil in a closet room, what will happen? This plant will die. In the same way, if the knowledge which you keep it inside within you and you don't share it, you don't imply it, you don't use it, you don't work on it, what will happen? It will go on waste. Like if you keep this in the door, and after that this dried green leafy twig is dried into this twig that its bark means the skin of the stem. This stem, the skin of the stem is coming out. It is easily crushed, broken and smashed. And then what you will do with this twig now? You will throw it into a dustbin. You will throw it in the dustbin. In the same way, if you don't use your knowledge in the proper direction, if you don't share it out, if you don't work with whatever energy, amount of knowledge you have gained from a brain, and you waste your time in other things, knowledge and wisdom, your hard working will go on waste. It will be thrown away without of no use. It will be destroyed and thrown in the dustbin. So children, the last paragraph it says, and someday when you open the door, you will think it only old twisted name. Like this, old twisted name. And sweep it into the dustbin with another rubbish. So what exactly the poet wants to tell over here, that tell to the readers that our life is like a twig, and it is going to bear fruit only if we plant it at a proper place and with a good heart and water it daily, and with the daily means the hard work. With the hard work and preservation, we will have a very good result. Now, sunlight is referred as God's love. Okay, in this poem, sunlight has been referred as God's love. When God sees that we are working very hard, the to plant this twig. He blesses us with what a good nourished tree, nourished with lots of leaves, flowers on it, and making it beautiful. But if you keep it in a closet, your knowledge, your goodness will become like this rusty, rotten twig, which can be crushed and thrown like an unwanted element in the society. ठीक है, it will be discarded as a useless thing. So children, you are a small children till now, and you take your life very light. Don't take life seriously. Mother says, पढ़ो पढ़ो पढ़ो. Oh mama, you have got lots of time. You want result? I give you a good result. But let me play now. Time flies off very fast, beta. That you don't even know the time has come, and your maths physics class is knocking on the door. Tuck 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 tuck. Beta, your exam is today. So when you open up and you come with a little mark. So don't waste your time. You have got the opportunity. Grow the same opportunity to study, study well, study hard, and so that you become a good citizen of the nation. Since you got the chance of study, and you also become a famous person. And if you don't take your life seriously, you don't study seriously. When you grow up one day, and when you grow up, and when you go for the hunting the job, you are landed up with a small package of salary. Then you regret throughout your life. So you got still time in the youth age to study hard and become famous like Emmy Lowell. She gave her example, as I told you, she never went to school, proper school. She did her studies at home, and later on with her hard work and preservation, she became a famous writer, and she was awarded with many, many prizes. Right, children? Now that's it. Have a good day and be a good child.